and we just have to remember our place. This is a note written by John F. Kennedy. John F. Kennedy had just gone over to the Soviet Union to meet with Khrushchev, and he was trying to get them to disarm, and he thought he was going to go over and change the world, but he was young, and all of the people, all of his advisors said, "You can't do it. You can't do it. You don't understand who Khrushchev is. He'll slaughter you." But he was arrogant, and he was young, and he went over, and he met with Khrushchev, and the advisors were exactly right. He was killed, and the press killed him. He got back onto Air Force One, and he was flying back over the ocean, and he went into his office on the plane just to write, and he was going to write a speech for the American people to explain he was sorry and to explain what had just happened. About halfway over the Atlantic, he buzzed his secretary, Evelyn Lincoln, and he said, "Ms. Lincoln, please come in and just clear all the papers out, throw them away." She said when she walked into his cabin, he was there and he had his head down on his table, on his desk, and he had just pushed all of the papers off onto the ground. She silently walked in through that airplane and she picked all of them up and she threw them all away except for this one, because she thought this was important. In her own hand at the very top, it says June 1961. This is what he wrote. "I know there is a God, and I see a storm coming. If he has a place for me, I am." And then he scratches that out and writes, "I believe I am ready. There's a storm coming. I know there is a God. I know he has a plan for each and every one of us. It's up to us to play our role at this time, to never ever give up, but trust that somehow or another it's going to work." Remember the movie Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory? When Charlie Bucket, everybody was trying to get Charlie Bucket to give up, and he goes and everybody except his grandpa was telling him, "You're never going to do it. You're never going to do it. You're never going to do it." Think of his family and think of his friends. Everyone said, "You're never going to do it. You're never going to make it." And in the end, because of fraud, he opened up a chocolate bar. And he got Willy Wonka's golden ticket. This is the Charlie Bucket golden ticket from the movie. What is our golden ticket? Our people have been told for decades, "You're not going to make it. Your voice doesn't matter. Sit down and take it. Don't talk about politics in public. Don't talk about religion in politics. Don't say things that make people uncomfortable. It is high time. Our golden ticket is the Constitution of the United States, and it requires us to stand up and say the uncomfortable things, to stand arm in arm with each other and protect and defend those rights for our children and our grandchildren. And the man who will do it, the man who will protect it, every waking day is a man that I have seen stand on that point, unwilling to give up his position because he's one of the only men there. He'll stand on the point no matter what the storm is, being stabbed in the chest, being stabbed in the back, having his head kicked in by the media, doesn't stop him because he has a fire in his bones. He knows his God, he knows his principles, and he respects the Constitution of the United States. He is our next president, Senator Ted Cruz.
Yeah. love America. Let me say to the men and women of Oklahoma, thank you for sending such a principled, freedom-loving, Constitution-defending warrior as Jim Bridenstine to defend you in the United States Congress. Let me tell you, Jim crawls over broken glass with a knife between his teeth. There's a reason that Jim and I both need food tasters in the members' dining room. Because when you stand up to the Washington bosses, they don't like it. But Jim remembers every day that he doesn't work for the Washington bosses, he works for the men and women of Oklahoma. And I got to tell you, I think from Jim's perspective, when you fought overseas and been shot at in the Middle East by bad guys trying to kill you, somehow Republican leadership doesn't look all that tough. And how about Glenn Beck? Isn't Glenn extraordinary? You know, every time I listen to Glenn, I learn something. Glenn is an educator. I love when he brings out his whiteboard. When he starts walking through the principles of the framers of our Constitution that built this country into the greatest country in the history of the world. When he starts walking through progressivism and how it is destroying both parties and destroying the country. You know what Ronald Reagan used to tell us? The scariest words in the English language are, "I'm from the government, and I'm here to help you." Really good definition of a progressive. Anyone who doesn't understand why those are the scariest words in the English language. I got to tell you, everyone gathered here, you're here because our country's in crisis. Because we're bankrupting our kids and grandkids. Because our constitutional rights are under assault each and every day. And because America has receded from leadership in the world and it has made the world a much more dangerous place. And yet, I'm here today with a word of hope and encouragement. All across Oklahoma, all across this country, people are waking up. This election is going to be about three key ideas: jobs, freedom, and security. Let's start with jobs. I want to talk to all the men and women of Oklahoma who are struggling right now under the Obama-Clinton stagnation. To all the single moms who are working 28, 29 hours a week, forced to be part-time because Obamacare kicks in at 30 hours a week. To all the working men and women with calluses on your hands who are finding yourself in a job where your wages are stagnant, they never seem to go up. To all the young people coming out of school with student loans up to your eyeballs and scared, am I going to get a job? What does the future hold for me? Well, let me tell you, if we keep doing what we're doing now, out of control spending and taxes and regulation, we're going to keep getting what we've got now. But there is a better way we can turn it around. And how do you turn it around?